and welcome to the Nalanda College Science Research Society's YouTube channel. We are here in conversation today with our very own Aya Gayanga Kuruppu. He's an incredible pioneer, researcher, and inventor in the fields of software development and healthcare, and one of our very own, and a past member of the Science Research Society. He has gained international recognition for the achievements that he has and the contributions that he has made towards software development and research. Here is a small intro video detailing his plethora of achievements and accomplishments. We are back in conversation with Gayanga Kuruppu. Hello, Ayi.
Hello. It's actually nice to see a society that you started, flourishing like this. It's actually brilliant to see.
We're actually trying as best as we can to continue the legacy that you started, Ayi.
That's good. Thanks for having me today.
So, Ayi, first to start off, we want to dive right in. I wanted to ask you, what is it that got you interested in the field of science research and software development? Did it come naturally to you, or was one a result of the other, or how did that happen for you?
I mean, I don't think it comes naturally. I mean, it sure does, but at one point you have to, have this urge to pursue something that you love. So how it started for me was, I was really curious growing up. I wanted to know why the clock ticked. So that is what actually made me get into scientific research. And software development, I would say pure passion, because I was making web applications since I was really small. Oh. And that made me get into software development. And what motivated me to carry on this far was probably the fact that the first competition I entered, organized by the National Science Foundation, I won the Intel Excellence in Computer Science Award for that. And that made me, motivated to carry out software development and scientific research.
So at about what age was your first software development competition?
The first software development competition would be in grade 7, maybe. Mm-hmm. And research competition would be 9, I think.
I mean, that goes to show how much of a achiever you are to start at such a young age, at 7 years old, software development. Moving on, so could you explain to us the scope of the research that you did that rendered so much critical acclaim?
Sure, that was, the last research that I did while I was at Nalanda College, which was, HealthPal. Basically, I made an Android application that interfaces with a medical device, an IoT medical device known as a pulse oximeter, and it continuously monitors a person's blood saturation and pulse. And mainly when the person gets into a health deteriorating condition, the variation spike and the pattern is different, right? These patterns are identified and, an alert is sent containing the variation of the patterns. And, the GPS coordinates of the person is sent whenever this person is having a deteriorating condition. So the research part of this was, I carried out a non-invasive clinical trial on 72 patients. And, to prove the accuracy and the effectiveness of my application. I mean, now that I think about it, there was so much I could have improved in terms of the application, including EKG, including machine learning techniques, neural networks into it, from my knowledge point right now. But at that point, that is what I did.
When you were developing the app, to find the parameters, did you also have to study things relating to deteriorating health and like the medical?
Of course, yeah. The domain knowledge in the field that you're researching is highly important. So basically, I had to go through a lot of domain research. You know, it's not just technical research, but domain research as well. So I was like very grateful because two of my uncles and one of my aunts are doctors. So I got a lot of help in that field. That field. So not just that, I had to go through a lot of literature and a lot of research papers to figure out, you know, to get all this domain knowledge needed to make an application like this.
Speaking of the literature and research papers, when you are doing a research, or as in most of the target audience are researchers, we want to know, how do you conduct that research? How do you find the research review, the gap where you have to do your own research, where you figure out what is missing? What do I have to find out? What is it that I have to commit myself to?
So it all comes out after you find a field that you're interested in. So it has to be a field that you're interested in, you know, something that, you know, you want to keep, you know, you keep track of, you know, day to day, you search what happened in this field and some a field that you're interested in. After you find this field, what you do is you go ahead and you do some, you know, basic research on this field and figure out what does this field need? What technologies does this field have right now? And what can I do to improve these technologies? You know, it's like this, the car wasn't, you know, built and put out in just one day, right? So it was a gradual progression of parts, you know, the side mirrors weren't there when it started out. But since the need for it was there, it was implemented. Same thing. So the main body is there. What you had to do is figure out what to do to improve whatever's already there. That's what scientific research is. So for that, you need the literature review. So in literature review, what you do is you go through various literary articles, peer-reviewed by other people, journal articles, and you basically write this review comparing each of these articles to see what's missing, what's already there, what can I do to improve this. You contrast all these articles together and you provide your own insight into it.
So, I mean, definitely to do that, you have to have a vast knowledge and you have to commit to reading as many research.
When you're reading, I would suggest you read, literature through sites like the Cornell University offers a site to read literature, and IEEE can be used. If you're into research like I am, like more computer science oriented research, I would highly suggest visiting paperswithcode.com. That gives you the research paper and the code base with it. So you can, you know, play around with the code base while studying.
It's almost like you're building, as in you're given a code and you're building upon it and improving it.
Actually, it's, let's say it's a research on neural networks, right? The person has done a research on a specific neural network and its effectiveness. So that neural network and the models he has used, he provides with the research paper.
Moving on. So during the time you were doing this research, you were studying, you had your education to pay attention to. What were the hurdles that you faced, the biggest hurdles that you had to overcome?
Okay, so research, I would say, I would say the clinical trial. Carrying out the clinical trial was by far the hardest part I had to do. So I had to do it in a proper way. I had to get ethical clearance from the MRI because it's, even though it's a non-invasive clinical trial, it's still a clinical trial. So you need ethical clearance to carry out these types of clinical trials. So getting this ethical clearance is by far the hardest thing, but that of course I was able to do with proper documentation and proper ethical standards. Another thing would probably be, you know, learning the ins and outs of research and learning what I don't know about software engineering. So both of those aspects, I think two people helped me out the most. Research, in the research aspect, Rakitamaleon helped me out a lot. And software development, another senior of our school, Nithila Vitanage, helped me out a lot as well.
Sorry, moving on, also your personal life, because conducting research, and in your case, not just conducting a research, but it's far beyond that, it can have a foreboding influence on your personal life as well. How did you manage that? Was it hard to take a step back from it sometimes?
I mean, I don't want to be cliche, but it's all about balancing, right?
Yes.
It's all about the balance. I mean, even though I was doing research, I didn't let it interfere with my schoolwork. And I was able to get through A-levels pretty successfully because of that. It's all about the balance, how much you put into all the aspects of your life, right? I mean, do research. That's a really good thing to do. But at the same time, you have to remember that balance is everything.
As I mentioned earlier, in your case, it's not just the research. It's development of an app, clinical trials, obtaining so much knowledge about the anatomy of a person, right? What did you do? What strategies did you adopt to take it beyond the research, to take it to the international platform? How did you achieve so much with it as you did?
I would say it all comes down to presentation. That's the key part of anything, any research, any development. The key part is presentation. Being confident in whatever that you developed, being confident in whatever that you researched on, whatever you studied, whatever you found out, and being able to present it in a manner that anybody can understand and anybody pays attention to you. I mean, doing a research without having an ability to present it is useless, because it's always about presenting it to a wider audience, you know, presenting it to the world. If you don't present it in a right way, nobody would understand what you did, what you accomplished. So I would say the key to gaining recognition on an international stage as well as a local stage would be presentation, being confident in what you develop and being confident as to present it to a wide range of people.
I mean, obviously, when someone does put in as much work as you did into a project, they do want to gain as much recognition, as much notoriety as they can. You know, and I guess that's where the primal human instinct comes in, that presentation really matters as opposed to just the content.
Exactly.
Yes. Since the time you did your research, have you noticed that that part of your life, as in what you were able to achieve, has affected your higher education or your career or however your future?
Yeah, I mean, of course, it has affected it very positively, I would say. I mean, yeah, so higher education, you need research for higher education. Although, like, a lot of people who are doing higher education in Sri Lanka don't focus that much on research, I think universities should focus a lot on research. So as I'm speaking right now, I'm doing this research on emotional recognition with machine learning algorithms and neural networks to make a smart mirror interface. So that's actually what I'm doing right now through my university. So I would say that it has affected very positively. The fact that I carried out research as a young researcher has given me this experience and this knowledge base to carry out with my research right now. And as for career paths, it opens a lot of career paths, especially because you learn new things, right? You learn emerging technologies. And because of that, I think my knowledge base is far ahead of my peers at this point. So that has opened up a lot of career paths as well for me.
So moving on, what kind of advice would you give to a young researcher who's just starting out in the field? As in, it is someone's first research and they're not very experienced or educated in the field?
I would say be confident in yourself, because if you're not your number one fan, nobody else would be, right? So be confident in yourself, be confident in your work. And I don't mean to sound cliche again, but learn from your mistakes. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. I've done so many mistakes when it comes to development and research. I mean, when I was doing HealthPal, every single day was a development hurdle that I had to overcome. And you have to learn from your mistakes. And through learning from your mistakes, you can actually make whatever you make a masterpiece. And that's basically what I'm going to offer as advice to anybody who's starting out. Don't be afraid to make mistakes and be confident in yourself.
I mean, speaking of which, I think it's important to point out to the viewers that it's not just that you are focused on research or software, it's that you are truly passionate about this field, that you are at the forefront of computer science and information technology, right? It's truly about passion and whatever you're willing to give to the field you love. Do you agree?
Yeah, exactly. It's all about passion, I would say. I mean, since I had a passion for software development, I was able to get this far into it, right? So what I'm saying is, even if you're doing research, do it in a field that you're passionate about.
So to conclude, if you're starting out as a software developer, or I mean, if you're even just learning computer science or coding, do you have any tips and tricks?
So I would say it's a really, really ever-changing, I mean, highly dynamic platform where everything's, you know, changing all the time. It's like science, like, you know, science always changes, right? Always improves, changes. It's like that. Whatever's valid today won't be valid tomorrow in software development, especially the technologies. So I would say learn the, you know, pay attention to the changing climate and adapt to the technologies, the changing technologies, and learn the new technologies as it changes. Because not a lot of these universities would teach you the latest tips and tricks. It's all about you learning. Nobody would teach you what's valid today. No university would do that because their syllabuses are outdated. So everything you do, what you learn, what you can do in this field is up to you and nobody else.
And I mean, it's an important field to learn because you cannot get away from it in the future. It's going to be everywhere.
Exactly.
It already is. It's an integrated part of our life as humans. To wrap up, is there anything else you would like to say to our viewers?
I would like to harp on the fact that, you know, be confident in yourself, learn from your mistakes, and follow research in a field that you're passionate about. That's mainly what I'm going to tell to all the viewers.
So thank you for joining us today, Aye, taking time out of your schedule to help us out and talk about your experiences and your trials and tribulations. Thank you again, and thank you to everyone tuning in. From the Science Research Society of Nalanda College, have a good day.